In the wild, fish don't really have to worry about the nitrogen cycle. In a vast mass of water, the nitrifying bacteria that break everything down are never going to be far away. But in a closed system like an aquarium, getting a balanced nitrogen cycle is essential if you want to keep your fish alive. Here's my ridiculously oversimplified analogy to hopefully bring you some clarity on the subject of just what on earth is the nitrogen cycle? So the usual starting point is to talk about ammonia, nitrite, and nitrate. But we're not going to do that today. Well, okay, we'll have to talk about them a little, but the unsung hero of my analogy is trusty nitrifying bacteria, the guy doing all the heavy lifting behind closed doors, the essential worker everyone forgets about, the person nobody realizes has quit until everything stops working. So, nitrifying bacteria, let's call him NB for short. He's the guy keeping the nitrogen cycle going. NB is the guy unclogging your sewage pipes, picking up your rubbish, and sorting out your recycling. And NB's job kind of goes in that same order of terrible job to slightly less terrible job. And this week, for your viewing pleasure, Bertie has donned his high-vis jacket to play the part. Cue the comments telling me that a better fish is the worst casting for a bin man in the world. Now, first up, NB, breaks down all the ammonia caused by fish poo and decay in the aquarium. He breaks down all this incredibly toxic waste into slightly less harmful rubbish called nitrite. But if left for too long, that rubbish can become even worse than the toxic ammonia it used to be. But have no fear, NB is here. He can also break down the nasty nitrite rubbish, composting it and sorting it into much less harmful recycling called nitrate. Now, NB does such a good job that this recycling can be left in the tank for quite some time without causing too many issues. But eventually, if you get a bit too much nitrate building up, even that will do damage. But this time, you don't need NB. Aquarium plants can absorb nitrate, which is why planted tanks are so great, and a simple water change will also dilute everything and make things safe too. It's kind of like the recycling plant sorting through your plastics to make your next soda bottle. Oh, and if you're enjoying these simple rubbish analogies, a sub to the channel would be tidy. So what we need to learn is not a chemistry lesson, but simply a lesson in how to keep NB happy in his work, sorting through all that waste. When you start an aquarium, ammonia doesn't magically appear, and although it is toxic, NB won't have a job to do if it doesn't exist. So adding some fish food or a couple of fish to start producing waste will create ammonia. This will get things started and give NB that tasty rubbish that he craves. Now imagine at this early stage that NB is on work experience. He's learning the ropes and not working quite as efficiently just yet. So whilst NB starts to populate in your tank, you need to give him a little helping hand, conducting daily 50% water changes so that he's not overwhelmed by the task. In order to support NB further, you'll also want to be dosing daily with a bacteria product like Seachem Stability for the first week or so, so the nitrifying bacteria successfully colonizes in your filter media, on your hardscape, within your substrate, on the tank glass, and on your plants. Basically, you're aiming for NB to be everywhere, cleaning up and breaking down all that fish waste. But even better than just using a bacteria product is to transport a new colony of NBs via already cycled filter media from other tanks and filters. I like to support bacteria colonization in a new tank by taking a small handful of filter media from one of my other filters and temporarily running a cheap hang-on-back filter with this media inside it. Think of this like buddying up your most experienced colleague with the work experience kit, helping them to get started and show them the ropes. A top tip here, if you are starting with your first ever tank, then it can be a good idea to ask your local fish shop if they will swap some new filter media for some dirty cycled media from their filters to put inside yours. Most good fish shops will do this, and whilst it might feel weird taking home dirty secondhand filter media, it's honestly one of the best things you could do. I'd really like to see more shops advertising this as a service, but the cynic in me thinks the margins on the filter start products are probably forcing their hand. Right, enough about fish shops, let's get back to NB. Now, once NB has learnt the ropes, you'll start to see the ammonia reduce as it gets converted into nitrite, and that too will start to reduce as it gets converted into nitrate. After about 2 weeks, you should start to conduct some simple water tests. The little strip test will be just fine, but if you want to be super accurate, you can invest in a fancy kit with liquids. Once you are seeing nitrite levels of less than 1 part per million and nitrate levels of less than 25 parts per million, you have successfully cycled your tank. You can, of course, also test for ammonia. But since it's the rubbish that we know nitrite has recycled into nitrate, we can now just concern ourselves with the occasional removal of that nitrate recycling via regular water changes. And now that everything is balanced and cycled, NB will continue happily in his work, not causing a fuss and keeping everyone in your tank safe. So there you go. Give nitrifying bacteria a good home and he'll do the rest. Oh, and if you think NB is pretty cool, you better check out my merch with the link in the description. Now, if you're interested in other benefits of the nitrogen cycle, you can explore how the nitrification process with undergravel filtration helps your plant roots by clicking the top card. And if you want to find out how I fertilize my tanks with an awesome method called estimative index, then you can click the bottom card. As ever, a like and subscribe is always appreciated, and I'll see you next time.